Good afternoon, all. Welcome to today's Cancer Healing Journey Talks. Myself, Annie Jones from Community Outreach Team of Zenonco.io and Love Heals Cancer. Cancer Healing Journey Talks helps cancer survivors and caregivers to share their journey with vast number of survivors and caregivers who have traveled or been traveling through this journey. This can inspire and motivate them for their faster recovery as well. Firstly, I would like to introduce today's speaker, Sister Maria. She is a cancer caregiver. Thank you, Sister Maria, for being with us today. So over to you. Can you please start with your introduction?
I'm Maria Carvalho. Started my journey from 1984 in after my MSc nursing. I did a specialization in trauma. After trauma specialization, I did again another specialization in rehabilitation of cancer patients. After that, I joined a post in Cancer Hospital as a principal senior tutor. Then within six years, I was promoted at Principal College of Nursing. We have started a College of Nursing and Principal College of Nursing. So we have a college since then. Then in 2015, I got retired from Tata Cancer Hospital. So almost after 24 years of life. That's it. Since I'm fully concentrated and I have a passion, even during my regular hours or in Tata, I used to go in the clinic and to give patients for palliative care. And trauma patients, because I've done the course there in trauma patients. Okay. So I got a passion to go give. After retirement, since 2015, after retirement, I joined Ostomy Association of India. Now I'm the head for the Ostomy Association, nursing aid for India. For all the conferences, web and in our patients' problems, specific problems, all that I do for them. And also in palliative care, I do for all the wounds. Wounds specialization is me. All the patients, difficult patients, are referred every day for consultations. And what are the therapies to go, different solution, how to take care of the wound. That's what I, at the moment, I'm in dealing with.
Okay. So can you please share how these patients are feeling when they come to know about cancer?
When the patients are they get shocked. They are many of them are unable denial. There is denial to them, accept the that it is cancer and stage of cancer. They don't know the staging. Important thing in cancer is staging. Which stage they belong to once they are come. Then if they are in a second, third stage, second stage, operative, non-operative, that also they are very much upset. It's operative or not, non-operative or not. And in a trauma, as far as the trauma is done, they accept the trauma on the abdomen. Just back, you can do it. I'll do, but not trauma. But we are seeing them and that because we have many thousand patients here who need a life. They drive, they go everywhere. So we show them videos and we convince them. Then they accept it. As in a palliative, we consult the palliative home care. We have got home care teams. We have got a caregiver. Whoever caregiver is there, we consult with counseling. We do telecounseling as well as counseling. And that's how we convince the patient that they go for bargaining. Many they go for other hospitals. Then they come back again. Sorry, they come back again and again consult. That's okay because we are used to this all consulting, going everywhere we accept because that is the state. They don't know.
Right. Yeah. So most of them are still reluctant to go to the doctor, right? After the diagnosis. So when they come to know the diagnosis. friends and when they think that they don't have any hope in their life. So how do you think we can motivate these people?
What we do, we are doing counseling. Stay with them and we motivate to hours counseling, one day. It's a follow-up, hope session, a simple session, both. First day, you go follow up again. By the time they know you are the person, because they also get information from the patients. How they do, what are the activity they do, how they help, everything. Then they get convinced that okay, there's no other way. Yes, okay, this is the way I need. And they see the videos because other patients are living. And they also interact with other patients. How do they to leave, talk, and all? Then they get self-motivated to undergo operation, undergo chemotherapy, all that. Okay.
Yeah. So, and also regarding colostomy bag, so most of them might be having this trouble when they try to put the colostomy bag at first go, right?
So yes, how do you convince the colostomy bag is a big problem. Colostomy is a big, they don't want the colostomy. They ask if you can do anything, but in some condition, when the cancer is in the rectum, when the anidase, we cannot omit the colostomy. And some patients having ulcerative colitis, which if you keep ulcerative colitis for years, it can turn into cancer. So we don't tell them this can turn into cancer. So we better do. And live a life which is enjoyable, which is fruitful, and live as other person, as enjoy ourselves. And we also enjoy. We have got picnics, we got joint meetings, all these things. Okay.
So did you as a caregiver have a support system of your own?
Yes, we have got support groups. And caregiver also is attached to support groups. Now, you know, for example, I'm completely attached to Ostomy Association. So there are 6 support groups in Ostomy Association. And each support group also, and another support groups are in each. For example, there's a Delhi support group. There are Bangalore support groups. Then there is a Kerala support group. And we are attached to interlinked with each other. So we know each other's phone. Any patient is there, we refer this patient. Support group. Support group is very important. And support group also, there are leaders in support group, which they conduct, often they conduct webinars. If they have problems, they conduct webinar. You want any problem, they conduct webinar. And they contact us. Let's do a webinar on, for example, hernia. Blockage. Or wound, scar of skin. In the trauma, there's a lot of skin problems. When you put the bag, they were to take out 10 times a day, 4 times a day. You should not take out the bag. Then we'll teach them how to put the bag, how to keep it for a year, how to change it, when to change it, what are the diet they must have. All these things we are teaching them. Then how to go about, how to have a bath, what to wear, what should not leak. Leakage is much problems there. So leakage should not happen in trauma bags. And patient should be completely confident. And nobody should know, identify from outside that smell. No, nothing should come. No identity should be there. All these things we take care of.
Yeah. So what are the obstacles you face during your treatment process?
Treatment process, obstacles. Many patients we find financial obstacles. Then is accommodation obstacles in Mumbai. Where to stay? Accommodation, financial. How many? Then how to go about what chemotherapy or radiation will be there? Chemotherapy will be there further. After operation, after this, all we also are in contact with social workers. With Tata Memorial social workers are contact with us. We refer the patient, this thing. And also NGOs. We have got 14, 10, 12 NGOs. where they have financial help, they give you the caregiver sati. There is one NGO, caregiver sati, that also gives us some help. Then we have NGO and many NGOs or like, so they help in different ways. Whenever we need, according to the need, we ask them.
Good. So what all things help in the recovery apart from the routine treatment? What are the other factors that help in ECS recovery of the patient?
First important is psychological acceptance. So you need counseling, mental acceptance, recovery, hope that they will be recovered, hope of the uncertain, and there is uncertainty of life. There's always hope for that, whatever this thing. Then we all the time counseling is required, continuous counseling, not one. Counseling from different angles, economic angle, physical angle, psychological angle, social angle, and also spiritual angle. Yes, spirituality also very important, because they are frightened to die. Many patients, they know they some stages there and they may die. So that also, I know why this, and many, they don't accept, they say, why this has come to me? Why this comes? So they bargain, they denial, all these things undergo them. So we identify the where they are, and then we do the counseling. In teleconsult, so we do, and I should do one-to-one counseling. Nowadays, all is teleconsulting.
Right.
And video calls. Like you, video, and sometimes Zoom meetings.
That's good. So why did you choose Ostomy Association? What was your reason behind choosing Ostomy Association and helping patients with colostomy bag?
Yeah, see, I'm specialized in ostomy. I've done the certificate after master's. I've done the certificate course in ostomy. And my hand skill, luckily, hand skill is and. It's very good, quite good hand skills. And whatever I prescribe for the ostomy patients, most of them are healed. They, after 20 years, 30, 25 years also, they're in contact with this. They are healed. And I also like, I don't like anybody personally undergoing any problems. And in my family, all of us are working for palliative care. My family uncles are having hospices in different places. So I go there also. Do there also. So attachment is an ostomy patients anywhere they cannot handle, they will refer to me. It may be not in Mumbai only. It can be Jaipur. It can be anywhere. Those people can refer. Now please tell me what to do. They will tell. And many times ostomy patients have blockages in the middle of the night. So mostly people don't take middle of the night cases, but I take any middle of the night cases also. So that's another important point where they like.
That's good. How do you manage your personal and professional life? I mean, together.
It is difficult. A little adjusting time. I have to adjust. If I get a little bit shouts from my husband or my family, family knows. Or my maternal family completely. They are also in this fellowship, so they know. They are completely aware of what I'm doing. But my only family problems at home, husband. Sometimes he interferes. So don't stop it. Forget about your patients. Now the demand is here. Like that. Until my son, children also know.
That's good. It's good that you're having a great support from your family itself, so that you can.
My little family completely support. Yeah. Because they are also doctors and they are also in different fields. Yeah.
That's nice, man. So can you share one of the story which actually touched your heart? I mean, throughout your career so far.
So, one story now touch. This will one story one patient of stomach patient only, young 46 years old man, he's a computer engineer. Mm-hmm. Computer engineer, he's having his own firm. But he had an ostoma 4 years back, 5 years back. Ostomy he had, and he had ostoma outside. His rectum was closed. Rectum is closed. And you know, within 2 years, 3 years, he got recurrence. That was shocking.
Yeah.
Yeah, recurrence, and the recurrence was, recurrence is not mild, simple recurrence on the that place. It's a multiple recurrence. He got recurrence in the lung, he got recurrence in the brain, he got recurrence in the nose, he got recurrence everywhere. So that was a very shocking, even everywhere. And he was very unable. As soon as he got the report, he told me, see, what is this? He referred to me and he told me, very touching. Even now, and I told only, let's pray to God. And doctor said, no operation cannot be done because it is spread everywhere. And you are a young man. Everywhere spread. We cannot touch anywhere. The cancer flaring and this thing. So, I'm still in contact with this man. He's alive. He's undergoing chemotherapy. Very touching.
So there are many patients or caregivers who are still going through their cancer journeys. If you could say one thing to them, what would that be?
Hope. I would say you have hope and pray to God. Mm-hmm. That's a prayer is very important. According to me.
Yeah.
Pray to God. God, have hope. Hope and faith. Faith, you'll become all right. That's only the 2-3
matches. Great. So how has your life changed due to the cancer? I mean, as a caregiver, and I know that your family is having a great support, and I think you should take care of yourself too. Yeah. Thank you so much, Maria ma'am, for being there with us today. Yeah, it was indeed really nice to talk with you.
Thank you very much. Okay, thanks. All the best.
Thank you, ma'am.